This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. The Virtual Theater is a computer game engine designed by Revolution Software to produce adventure games for computer platforms. The engine allowed their team to script events and move animated sprites against a drawn background with moving elements using a point-and-click style interface upon its first release. It rivaled competing engines like LucasArts' SCUMM and Sierra's Creative Interpreter. Due to its then high level of artificial intelligence, the engine was first proposed in 1989, while the first game to use it, Lure of the Temptress, was released in 1992, followed by Beneath a Steel Sky 1994, Broken Sword, The Shadow of the Templars 1996 and Broken Sword 2, The Smoking Mirror 1997. It allowed in-game characters to wander around the game world independently of each other, performing everyday life actions, which was not previously possible, and all characters and objects occupied space. Consequently, non-player characters had to sidestep the player's protagonist and any other object they came across, as well as the player having to sidestep them, achieving a more realistic game world that previous engines were unable to provide. Though non-player characters could unwittingly block a path as the player was traversing the game scene, non-player characters performed much simpler tasks with each release due to size constraints. Two games, Broken Sword, The Shadow of the Templars and Broken Sword 2, The Smoking Mirror, that use a virtual theater variant engine can now be played on modern hardware using SCUMVM, which as a result allows the engine to run on platforms where the titles were not officially released in 2012. It was confirmed that the engine will be revived as Virtual Theater 7 for the upcoming fifth Broken Sword titled Broken Sword, The Serpent's Curse 2013. Contents: 1. Development. 2. Features. 3. References. 4. External links. Development: Charles Cecil and Tony Warner had worked together at Arctic Computing, an English video game development company, in 1990. They decided that they would set up their own video game development company, together with David Sykes and Noiran Carmody, for their debut adventure game, Lure of the Temptress, released in 1992 for Amiga, Atari ST, and PC. Cecil, Warner, Sykes and Dan Marchant created the concept of the game engine titled Virtual Theater, which Warner wrote for Beneath a Steel Sky, released in 1994 for Amiga, and PC. Revolution used an updated version of Virtual Theater, Virtual Theater 20, written by Warner and Sykes. However, because the game was 6 times the size of Lure of the Temptress, non-player characters had to perform much simpler tasks than in its predecessor Broken Sword, The Shadow of the Templars, released in 1996 for PC, Mac and PlayStation, and its sequel, Broken Sword 2, The Smoking Mirror, released in 1997 for PC and PlayStation, also used modified versions of the Virtual Theater engine. The engine got various updates since then for Broken Sword, The Serpent's Curse. A brand new engine, VT7, was developed in order to deal with multiple platforms and, in particular, screen resolution. The system is built on C and OpenGL, and a custom scripting language to implement the game itself. Features: traditionally in adventure game engines, non-player characters were static, awaiting the player to interact with them to trigger an event. However, Virtual Theater allowed non-player characters to traverse the world in seemingly random patterns, interacting with their environment upon the engine's first release. It rivaled competing engines such as LucasArts' SCUMM engine and Sierra's Creative Interpreter. Due to its then high level of artificial intelligence, another advantage of the engine is that it is a cross-platform engine. It was also faster on the Amiga than the C code that was used by many USA programmers at that time compared to the Sierra titles. The engine became in this respect more sophisticated, a reason why Revolution did the conversion of King's Quest VI to the Amiga. All of the in-game objects, including non-player characters in Virtual Theater, occupied space, which was a unique feature for an engine at the time. Consequently, non-player characters had to sidestep the player's protagonist and any other object they came across, as well as the player had to sidestep them when a non-player character bypassed the protagonist. He or she uttered a comment like, "Excuse me, sir." As the result, the engine achieved a more realistic game world than previous engines were able to provide. Though non-player characters could unwittingly block a path as the player was traversing the game scene, this was remedied with the release of Broken Sword, The Shadow of the Templars, where the protagonist, if found his way blocked by another character, could simply walk through them. Two games, Broken Sword, The Shadow of the Templars and Broken Sword 2, The Smoking Mirror, that use a Virtual Theater variant engine can now be played on modern hardware using SCUMVM. Consequently, Consequently, those games using the engine may run on the platforms the titles were not officially released on. References AB Edge Staff May 9, 2008 The Making of TEDxLeads, Charles Cecil 10 September 09. Fuente, Derek Della July-August 1993 Beneath a Steel Sky Joystick, Issue 40, p. 93. Hachette Disney Press. Game Engine Recreation List Game Creation System Free and Open Source 2D Adventure Game Studio Beats of Rage Cocos 2D Flixel Joger Kirikiri Lib GDX Moi OHR RPGCE Open FLORX Pygame Renpi Strategus 1000 Parsec Vassal XCONQ 25D Aleph 1 Cube 3D Away 3D Blender Game CAFU Crystal Space Cube 2 Delta 3D Dim 3 GU Create Glycine Horde 3D HPL 1 Earlicht Id Tech 3 Id Tech 4 J Monkey Ogre Open Wonderland Panda 3D Papervision 3D Platinum Art Sandbox Free 3D Game Maker PlayCanvas PLIB Quake Quake 2 RealmForge Retribution Torque 3D Mix Allegro Construct Classic Godot Lightweight Java Game Library Spring Wintermute Engine Proprietary 2D Construct 2 Corona ClickTeam Fusion GameMaker, Studio GameSalad Muggin End Scripter RPG Maker Southpaw. Stencil Ubiart Framework Vicious Virtual Theater V Play Zillions of Games 3D 4A Amazon Lumberyard Anvil Bork 3D C4 Chrome Clausewitz Engine Creation CryEngine Crystal Tools Diesel. Dunia EAGL Ego Elflight Enforce Enigma Essence Flare 3D Fox Frostbite Geomod Golds RC HeroEngine HydroEngine HPL 2-3 Id Tech 5 Id Tech 6 Ignite IW Jade Kinetica LS 3D Lithtech Luminous Studio Lin Marmalade Mizuchi Mount Framework Outera Panda Ray FieryEngine Q Real Virtuality Redengine Refractor Riot Rage Sage Sirius Shark 3D Shiva Silent Storm Source Titan Toshi TrueVision 3D Unigen Unity Unreal Vision Visual 3D XN Gine X-Ray Yeti Zero Mix Gamebryo Hybrid Graphics Kineva Game Platform Metismo Historical Interest Brender Build Dark Doom Game Maker GameMaker Gary Kitchens GameMaker Genesis 3D Genie Filmation Freescape Insane Jedi Made Pie in the Sky Renderware Sim RPG Maker Sith Voxel Space Wolfenstein 3D Proprietary Middleware List Euphoria Gameware Gameworks Havoc iMuse Kinapps Quazzle Speedtree Zaitment FaceGen